I think actually the thing that comes home to me most strongly listening this afternoon is that almost everything that's been said could have been said by almost any elector aged between 18 and 65 or older. That the criticism is centred around the way politicians present their arguments, and it's said that we don't present them in a way that take the electorate seriously. I think that's something that isn't confined to young people. And when you criticise politicians, what you're criticising primarily, I think, is the way we present those the difference between the two parties. And that's a perfectly fair criticism, which I think most politicians, in fact, in their more honest moments, would accept. The one thing that I don't think is the answer to that problem is to say, well, we're going to back out of the system altogether. The reason why I'm involved in it is precisely because I don't think some of my elders do it in the way that I would prefer to see them do it. That's what got me involved in politics, and that's why I make no apology for remaining involved and really for asking for your support to actually try to put right some of the things that you've been saying is wrong, and I agree with you are wrong.
Well, I think Stephen is partly right when he says that we meet the same kind of cynicism for politicians from people aged 6 to 66. But I think that many of those who've already spoken have an important point when they complain about the lack of political education that people are given in schools. And I think that we as politicians cannot expect people at 18 to take part in the political process when they get no education about how the political system operates. And not just about how Parliament operates, but how you as individuals and you as members of a democratic society can take part in that society and can exercise the power which the law gives you. The law gives you all this power, but you're not taught, and I wasn't taught, how to use it. And so it's not surprising, as many people have said tonight, that you leave school or leave college at 18, you're given the vote, and you think, well, what the devil am I going to do? How do I exercise that vote? How do I make the choice? People aren't taught enough about their rights, and I think that is at the root of the disaffection that many young people feel for politicians.
In the whole of the series, we've been talking about the fact that people can't go and see the films they want to see, they can't drink in the pubs they want to drink, etc., etc. What can your parties do to actually improve the situation, Jack?
The key to effective political action is working through groups. That's where ANL and Rock Against Racialism worked. And if you feel that strongly about something, whether it's about a local issue or a national issue, form a group. Don't wait for other people to form a group. Two or three of you can form a group, give it a name, and then write to your members of parliament, write to the newspapers, hold demonstrations, and in that way you'll get things changed.
Stephen?
Yes, I go along with that. If there's a group of people who want to change the law, the political system is, I think, sufficiently flexible to allow them, first of all, to put their point of view, and secondly, to see a shift in emphasis as a result of their having done it and done it effectively.
Stephen Dorrell, Jack Straw, thank you very much.